Welcome back to my channel, friends. This side Sonia here from Growing Craft, and if you have not subscribed to my channel, please hit the subscribe button. Today I have some very basic supplies, but the project that I'm going to do is really cute. So I have my fabric cushion cover, my Mod Podge, and this is one of the beautiful decoupage napkin which I got recently. Yes, I keep on buying decoupage napkins and I absolutely love them. So this one has a typewriter with a text I love you written on it, and some cute colorful butterflies flying out, and I thought of using this on my cushion cover. So initially when I bought this napkin, I had planned to do this on my MDF base, but somehow I felt that this is going to look really nice in this cushion cover. So just in case, if you want to see the collection of my MDF bases, please do comment below. Maybe I can show you my huge collection of MDF bases. Now I have teared down my decoupage napkin and I'm going to remove the layers, and I have just used my heat gun to speed up the drying process of the edges, and it becomes super easy to remove your plies. So now we are going to need our Mod Podge and we need to stick this. Now, as you know that fabrics are really thin, the adhesive or the Mod Podge can really move out from the sheet of that. So it's always better to use a plastic sheet beneath that or any cardboard, but it's better to have a plastic base so that it does not stick. Initially, I thought I will use my acrylic block, but then I realized that my acrylic block was not really very clean. It had some paints, and of course if I use my Mod Podge, there are chances that those color may get wet and stick to my cushion cover. So that's the reason I thought of using a clear clean plastic, which I got from my stencil pack. So now once I've decided that how I'm going to place my text and on the center part approximately, I just made sure that my plastic is just exactly beneath the my decoupage napkin. Now this process is really easy, but with this very simple technique you can do n number and varieties of home decor products. So here with my flat brush I'm applying my Mod Podge, and I'm quite generous when I apply my Mod Podge, cause I completely believe that Mod Podge is something which really sticks your project really well to your base, and it is one of the very important thing. Now with a sponge jobber I am pressing my decoupage napkin, and you have to be really gentle when you are using your sponge jobber, cause you really can't just press it really hard. And I will also try to stick it very nicely from the edges, cause at times you don't realize it but the edges don't stick really well. Now this looks really good. I'll just make sure that my plastic has not sticked to it. It is not going to stick, don't worry about it. I'm just removing it once and then I'm going to let it dry for at least 3 days. This is the third day and my project has dried out completely, means completely. It is completely dry, and see, can you really see how matte it looks? And that's the best part of using your matte finish Mod Podge, and I absolutely love it. Still the plastic sheet is inside the cushion cover, which I'm going to keep as it is, and I'm going to have good 2 layer of Mod Podge in this. Now in this video I'm just showing you one top layer of Mod Podge, and once I'm done with this layer of Mod Podge, I will keep it to dry for at least 2 days, and then I'm going to have my third layer, for which I have not shot in this video tutorial. And with this my project is done, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. And yes, if you are going to try this, please do let me know that how it turned out. I will be really happy to know how your project came out. And yes, I'm listing all the supplies down in the description box. Do check that. If you have any queries, please do comment below. I'll be more than happy to help you guys. Thank you so much for watching. Take care. Bye-bye.